the scientific laboratories, biological laboratories, where they're doing absolutely bizarre things with various creatures. Yes or no?
Yeah.
All that is done with the intention of well-being. How much well-being comes out of it? We don't know, isn't it?
Aghori. That means he's beyond the terrible, that the terrible does not touch him. There is nothing that is repulsive for him. He is an all-embracing kind, not in compassion. Because I want you to understand that spiritual process in this part of the world never taught you about being loving, being compassionate, being kind. This kind of stuff, they did not even consider it as spiritual. So they thought it was not necessary to teach such things. So Aghori is in an embrace with the existence, not in any kind of emotion, simply because he wants to be like life. Because life is naturally all-embracing. He treats food and his excrement the same way. He treats the dead and the alive the same way. He treats a well-preserved body and a rotting body the same way. Not because he's in love, simply because he wants to become absolute life. He does not want to be trapped in his own psychological process.
Even in a high school, if you study biology, you are cutting open frogs and looking into this and that.
Yeah.
It's quite bizarre.
Yep.
Isn't it quite bizarre?
Yes, it is.
It's quite bizarre, but all of us have done it and continuing to do it as if that's the only way to learn. So, what they are doing is, as I said, there is still prana in the body that is dead. They don't want to do a live person because it will lead to human sacrifice. They don't want to do that. They're waiting for the dead to come. What energy is released from the dead body, from cremation, they want to use that. If you do not know the science of that, you cannot just think it's all bizarre. So they're sitting there. If you go there to Manikarnik and Harishchandra Ghat, Aghoris will be sitting there watching. Everybody who will come, they inquire, how old is this person? How did he die? That's why some of them who don't want that to be known, they're covering with plastic sheets, you know, where people cannot see. How old is the person? They won't say, how old was the person? But the Aghoris want to know. If it's a young person, somebody who has vibrant life and for some reason he died, they want that kind. When that happens, they want to do work there. They want to make use of the energy that's released. Once the body begins to burn, this prana has to exit immediately. When that exits, they want to make use of that life energy to do something with themselves.
By that logic, we can define any, you know, we can justify any perversion.
See, they are not causing harm to anybody. Never are they causing harm to anybody. Have you heard of any Aghori attacking anyone?
No.
No, he is doing something with himself. See, people are taking drugs, people are drinking themselves to death, people are smoking and blowing it in your face. They're not doing any of those things, they're in remote places doing their own thing with themselves, not with somebody else.
Yeah, that's the point, that's the point. They are free to do what they want.
Only with themselves, they're not doing it with anybody else.
As far as they don't, yes. As far as they don't scare the society, as far as they don't...
See, the scaring the society is because society has just... populations have exploded and we are just everywhere.
Yeah.
Where is a secluded place, tell me?
That's a point. That's a point that if they want to live...
And this explosion of population is society's... Society is the culprit, not Aghoris. They don't reproduce at least.
Yeah. So then that over-glorification of Aghoris when we hear that they've got these superpowers and all that, that probably is exaggeration and they are selfish, self-centered, experimental beings.
What is super and what is not super is again contextual. Their thing is not about powers. It is just about they want to evolve to a place where what you hold as something that you abhor, they are trying to befriend that, because the moment you like something and moment you dislike something, you have divided the existence. And once you divided the existence, you cannot embrace it. So they're going with whatever you would not be able to stand. What is most abhorrent for you? That is what they befriend, because they want to take away what they like and what they do not like. Everything is same to them.
So
this is a way of embracing the universe.
Now, one strange way of doing it. What do you on the other hand, you have this…
Strange or otherwise, successful for some people, that's all that matters. It works.
Yes.
It is not for you and me, but for somebody it works. I am not against anything that works. If it works, it's fine with me.
Yeah, but it works for them, and they can't ever tell you how it works for them.
Yes.
They can say that I'm happy, so let me be. That's what they can say.
They're not even talking about happiness. We know it works.
Yeah. I mean, it works, okay, in a certain way. You can
because
define…
certain transformation, certain capabilities they display, which is otherwise not possible.